Hi guys, this is Rajasekhar, assistant professor from Engineering College Bikaner, IT department. Today I want to explain one of the important concepts from PPS subject, that is number systems. Actually, this is the concept from under our second unit. So actually we have two concepts in our second unit. The first one is the number system and second one is the complement system. So from these two concepts you will get 35 marks in your university exams. Those who are under BTU, I am talking about them. Okay, let's go to the definition of the number systems. Number systems are the technique to represent numbers in the computer system architecture. Every value that you are saving or getting into or from computer memory has defined number systems. Means in computer, every data is treated as a number. So already we know computer is a machine, it can understand only the binary information. Binary means it is in the form of zeros and ones, means zero is a number and one is the number. So the every information in a computer is in the form of numbers. So for representing these data in the form of numbers, we are expressing some different numbers for representing those data. So actually, what is the need to learn this concept? Because of we know computer is a hardware device also. So the hardware device means the motherboard is made up of with different digital circuits. So each digital circuit is a combination of some gates. So gate means it can accept the information in the form of zeros and ones. So for making this functionality of the gates, we should learn about the number systems. Means we have to give the information to the gates, so in the form of numbers, so we should learn about these numbers. So basically, according to our syllabus, we have mainly four types of number systems. First one is the binary number system, second one is the octal number system, third one is the decimal number system, and fourth one is the hexadecimal number system. What is binary number system? We know binary information is in the form of zeros and ones. Here we have only two numbers, that is 0 and 1. So we can represent the data in the form of two ways, that is 0 and 1. So the base is 2. Why the base is 2? Here we have only two numbers, either 0 or 1. So every number within the form of zeros and ones with the base 2, that is called the binary number. So octal number. So what is the use of octal number? Here we have a binary number, but for representing this binary number, we have to maintain the length of the size of the binary is very more than the octal number. So we have to reduce the length of this binary number, we can go to the octal number. So we can represent the numbers from 0 to 7, that is called the octal number system. Means that is the base 8, means we have the numbers here from 0 to 7, so total 8 numbers. So that is the binary number system. So here the octal number base is 8 because of here we are representing the numbers from 0 to 7. So decimal number system, we know commonly our familiar numbers like from 0 to 9, daily we are using these decimal number systems. So here we have numbers from 0 to 9 is 10 numbers, the base is 10. Same like that hexadecimal number system. Here when you want to represent the data in the form of large values, means I want to reduce the length of the binary more, when at the time I can use the hexadecimal number systems. Means you are adding 6 digits to the decimal number, means here we have a 15, 0 to 15 numbers, means here total we have 16 numbers, so the base is 16. But here you have to remember one thing, here from 0 to 9 we can represent the numbers in the form of 0 to 9 because of we have here single digits. But here from 10 to 15, here we have two digits, 10 11 12 13 14 15. But I have to represent this 10 as a single number, 11 is a single number, but according to computer 10 it can be treated as a 10, and 1 1 1180 can be treated as a 1 1. So because of that thing, I am going here 10 as a 11 as a b, 12 as a c, and 13 d, like that 15 is a f. So in hexadecimal, when you are getting these numbers, then you can place with these alphabets. Just remember, don't forget, because of this is one of the important thing you have to remember. So these are the four types of information, four types of number systems in our concepts. So those so these are the important concepts in our number systems. So please remember these four types. First one is the binary, second one is the octal, third one is the decimal, and fourth one is the hexadecimal. So remember here also one thing, we have to convert from each number system to other, means binary to octal, binary to decimal, binary to hexadecimal. Same like that, octal to binary, octal to decimal, octal to hexadecimal. Same remaining also, hexadecimal to remaining 3, decimal to remaining 3. So total we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 into 3 means total conversions are there for representing the data. So second one, next, what is the conversion? First, I will explain about decimal to remaining 3 conversions. Means decimal to any radix. Here radix is nothing but a base. Here I have a data in the form of decimal. I am converting this decimal data into any base, means like decimal to binary, decimal to octal, and decimal to hexadecimal. So for representing this data from decimal to other radix, we have a method. That is the method. Here I am explaining step by step process. First one is the take the given decimal number. For example, I am giving a number 44 base 10, means 44 base 10 means this is the decimal number, convert into binary. So this is our problem. First, for solving this problem, I am going into these steps. If you are following these steps, you can solve this problem easily. So first step, take given decimal number, means what is the given decimal number here? 44. So I am taking this given decimal number 44, and step 2, divide that given number with the wanted base of the number. So given the given number, so here 44 is the given number, so please divide this number with wanted base. What is the base, what is the number here, binary, what is the base of the binary? 2. So please divide that number with 2. So here this is the process. So 44 is the number, I am dividing this number with 2, because if I am converting this number into binary. So next one is step 3, write the reminders in each phase. So when you are dividing this number, if you are getting any reminder, just place here aside of that number. Okay, next step 4, write reminders from bottom to top as answer. So after dividing completion, here write the answer from bottom to top. So this is your answer. This is very simple. When you are converting from decimal to any radix, just remember the thing is a divide method. Number of people will be confused. I have seen number of times some of the people are confusing when converting these numbers. Just I am giving one trick here. When you are dividing from decimal to any radix, just remember this division method. Means you want to divide the given number with what is the number you want with that base. Means just remember one of the trick here, DD. So when we are converting from decimal, that is the starting letter D, when you are converting into that number, so you can use this method like division. So when you are dividing the decimal to any radix, use the division method. How we can use the division method? With the base of the number, what do you want, convert this number. So you can follow these four steps, then you can find the answer. So here let's see the example. 44 is divided by 2, I will get the 22. Here no remainder. 22 divided by 2, I am getting 11. Here no remainder. 11 is divided by 2, I'm getting 5, but here remainder is 1. And again 5 is divided by 2, I'm getting 1 is the remainder. So here I'm writing the number from bottom to top. So here bottom to top, like 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0 means 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. So the 44 base 10 is equal to 101100. If you want to check this answer is correct or not, I can give the one shortcut method, that is the 2 power n formula. Here you can use 2 power n formula like this. You can increase the n value from 0 to 1, 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on up to n, like this. 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, 2 power 4, 2 power 5, up to like that. Okay. 2 power 1, 2 power 0 means 1 value, that is the 2 power 1 means 2, 2 power 2 means 4, 2 power 3 means 8, 2 power 4 means 16 and so on like that. So what is the number you want here? Here I want the number represented in the form of binary, that is a 44. So 44 means, so what is the number under 44 means 32, after 32 you will get the 64. So 44 is less than 64, then take this less than 64 numbers. Okay, so I am representing 32 plus 8 plus 4, 44. Those where I am using these numbers, I am putting 1, remaining I am putting 0. So 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. So previously I got this answer same. So this is the correct. So if you want to direct represent the number from decimal to binary, you can use this method also, no problem. Okay, next one is the, for example, I am converting the number from decimal to octal. So any number means every number from decimal to any radix, that is only one method, that is the division method. So here 44, I am dividing the method, dividing by using the, that's four steps, dividing by using this base, because if I have to convert this base into octal. So 44 divided by 8, so I am getting 5 times, but the remainder is 4. So after dividing completion, just write from bottom to top, don't forget this thing, because of number of people after writing these things, you are all are writing from top to bottom, it is very wrong. But you have to remember here, you have to write the numbers from bottom to top, 54 base 8. Okay, here I am giving one of the logic also. If you are getting numbers from large base to small base, the number will be increased. Means if your number is converting from large base to small base, then your converted number is greater than previous one. Means you are getting 44 base 10, here the base is 10. You are converting this number into small base, so the number will be increased. Means if you are getting greater than 44 number, then your answer is correct. Otherwise, if you are getting less than 44 number with base 8, your answer is wrong. Just check this answers like that also. For example, I am converting another thing from decimal to hexadecimal. Same thing, take the base of that number what you want convert, and take the given number, divide the given number with that base of that new number, then I am getting 2 times and the remainder is the 12. So 2 12. But I told you about one thing here, when you are representing the numbers from 10 to 15, you have to use alphabets, because of this is a single number like 12, it's not 1 2. So here I am going for representing 12 as a C. So the answer is 2C base 16. So next one is the example. Previously we have seen that examples without any fractional value. For example, in your problem, you have a fractional value, then what can I do? So like that, for example, here we are seeing here, one of the example, 44.5 base 10 to base 2 means decimal to binary. So any number from decimal to binary means anything decimal to any radix, you have to use the division method. It's a D D. Just remember, don't forget this trick, because of If you remember the trick, then you can easily solve this problem without any confusion. So 44, okay, here I can explain how you can do these fraction problems. First, you can take the integer separate and fraction as a separate. So you can apply same thing for integer like a previous problem. Means 44 divided by 2, why you are dividing by 2? Because of you are converting into binary, the base of the binary is 2. So you are getting this answer 101100, same previous problem. But what about fraction value? Here fraction value is 0.5. So take the fraction value and multiply with the new base. So for fraction value multiplication, but integer is the same division method. So fraction value you have to multiply with that number. Okay, that base number. 0.5 into 2 is equal to 1.0. That is the, so after multiplication, if you are getting any integer value here, then take the integer value side and take again fraction value. So 0.0. So into again 2. If you are getting 0 here, there is no problem. If you are not getting 0 here, you have to solve up to getting 0. Otherwise, up to at least 10 values you have to produce. Okay, just remember, if you are getting here the integer value is 0, there is no problem. That is the your last step of the for multiplication. Otherwise, you have to solve up to 10 steps. Otherwise, up to 0. Okay, so here I am taking 1. After that, here you have to write from bottom to top. Okay, just 10110. But when you are doing the fraction value, we have to write from top to bottom. Just remember, for multiplication, top to bottom means reverse. Just here, bottom to top, here, top to bottom. Next one is the another example, like same using octal number, means so decimal to octal. Same like that for fraction value and same like that for multiplication. Means I am dividing 44 with 8. I am getting 54 and I am multiplying with that fraction value of that new base of that number. So 0.5 into 8, that is equal to 44.0. So I am getting here 4, because of I am putting this 4 aside and I am taking again the 0 into a fraction and take multiplication with 8, that is equal to 0. So here I am getting 0, then I can stop here. Otherwise you have to do up to 10 values, otherwise up to what when you are getting this 0.00. so the answer is 54.40. means here 54, and you have to write from top to bottom with the fraction value. So 54.40 base 8. Okay guys, this is the concept from decimal to any radix. So again, I am giving the overview. When you are taking the number from decimal to any radix, means decimal to any base, like decimal to binary, decimal to octal, decimal to hexadecimal, or decimal to any radix, you have to use only division method. How we can divide? By using the new base of that number. You have to divide with the base of that new number. So here I am giving some exercises problems, just to be solving this. Solve these problems and please answer me these problems in comment section. Okay, thank you.